Guten Tag, sprechen Sie Deutsch? No, the Movie Palace. And welcome back to another episode where we watch movies, some of which we've seen and some we haven't, and give you our commentary and feedback as filmmakers ourselves. Today we are joined not only by a special beverage, but by a special guest as well. On our watch through today of Monty Python and the Holy Grail, we will be drinking the Holy Hand Grenade. As always, I'm joined by my two lovely co-hosts, Jack Hale, professional Hamptons cowboy, and Brianna Ramirez, our friendly neighborhood Spanish translator. Our special guest is one that you've seen before, and one that you were probably hoping not to see again, but it's Gavin. Here he is.
He's the only one whose manager got back to us.
Thought we kidnapped him.
My manager's my mom.
Do the Latin bit.
In nomine Patria, Filio, Spiritus Sancti. Amen.
Today we're going to be watching the 1983.
This is Gavin's game. This is Gavin's game. For those of you that don't know, Gavin is really, really good with numbers, but not in the way that's important. The way that helps him guess movie titles and when people were born and died.
Yes. That's a very apt description of it. I said 83.
1975.
Really?
Yeah. This is like my favorite Monty Python movie. I watched this all the time growing up. We were a big Spamalot family, you know, whiteys. I say this a lot, but it's one of the first movies I watched where I was like, I noticed that it was unique.
Obviously, there's the whole twist at the end with it being like, beep, but it has such a like a rinky-dink feel to it.
Yo,
spoiler alert.
There's one person here who hasn't seen it at all.
Yeah.
Oh.
Bri has never seen this. Let's start it.
This movie.
The Monty Python comedy clan skewers King Arthur and his Knights of the Round Table as they quest far and wide for the Holy Grail.
You know, Monty Python is what your mom calls my dig.
You could have gone with Mounty Python. That's what I call your mom.
Wait, they've got credits in the beginning like this?
Just wait, because there's a bit. They're doing a bit with it.
They're doing a bit.
Got it. This is the epitome of...
It's a bit.
Wait.
The U.S. has to bring that term back. Not even back.
Sacked?
We've never really even used that.
We definitely have. The directors of the firm hired to continue the credits after the other people were sacked wish it to be known that they have just been sacked. The credits have been completed in an entirely different style.
This is one of the movies that does handheld really well. This is a slow zoom we were talking about the other day.
What was it shot on?
Film. 16mm film.
That's what makes it feels so rinky-dink. Is the 16mm.
Well, this entire bit with the horses was invented because they couldn't afford horses. King of the Britons,
defeater of the Saxons. I love that shot so much.
It's the two of you. Who will join me in my court
at Camelot. This is accurate. Oh, there's that morning voice. There it is. What do you mean? That's what we were worried about, right, folks?
In other news, there is flooding across the United States of America as every woman gushes with desire for Alex Brooks' voice.
Not every woman. Just the one that matters.
You were saying that, that they're a comedy troupe?
Yeah, so Monty Python is like a comedy troupe, and they did a lot of stage things too. This is what I wanted COVID to be like, and I'm really disappointed that it wasn't. Do you kind of see why this was on my list of inspiration films? You probably will.
I'm sure as the movie goes on, I will.
This is what you're going to do to me when I get elderly.
I like in that circumstance, I'm not elderly. Yeah. I'm still young. Only you are elderly.
I'm talking about like 8 years from now.
I was just going to say, elderly for us is like, it's an accelerated timeline.
Yeah. Will you shut up? Now we see the violence inherent in the system. Dude, where's the body cam?
It's like that scene in Shrek 2 where they reenact cops.
Oh, dude, this is such a good fucking bit. I love this one so much. This is so good.
Is this just gonna be every new scene where like, oh, this is my favorite? No.
But look at this fight choreography. It's not only hysterical on its own, but like, it's so silly, it's so goofy, I love it. This is Gavin and I in the mornings.
I'd knock on your door like, hey, wake up, and then...
It reminds
me of the fucking sword.
Let me know if this reference is...
I just
fucking broke my
shit. Right in the eye slits.
Okay, SFX.
The special effects in this movie go crazy.
Yeah.
Especially considering what they spent on the movie.
I feel like you have to find stuff like this on the day.
I think they probably did his take in a series and just got the one reverse.
Oh,
this guy.
100%. I wonder if they also originally had him saying stuff.
Well, that's the beauty of the mask, is like it gives you the option. You're going to end up dubbing over it, so it doesn't even make sense to record sound on location. Alex, if you and I ever fought, this is exactly how it would go.
Who's who?
Oh, I'm the Black Knight for sure.
Okay.
No. Like, I'm getting my ass kicked, but I will not admit it.
Sing it, guys. Smacking myself silly over here.
I'm not that committed to the bit.
Yo, have you seen those videos where they're like, if I was in this era, you test me, bitch. She's a witch. Get her.
We need to bring back burning people at the stake.
I thought you were gonna say we need to bring back witches. And
no, they still exist.
That's what I was gonna say.
They're on TikTok now.
Oh, they
they're
are.
On TikTok.
They witches are
girls.
Fucking alive and well,
kids
dude.
Kids are damn TikTok.
They've got crystals. Now.
You say that as if you don't actively have.
Why do witches burn
Ayo,
in your
ladies,
living room?
Ayo, ladies, I got
I don't
crystals,
have crystals
too. All right.
In my living room, I have them in my bedroom.
Oh my God, my crystals and my feminist literature books.
Wait, she weighed the same as the
No.
So of course she didn't.
No.
They had faulty equipment.
Yeah, it was like they lined up for like up. They lined up for like 2 seconds and like she weighs the same.
My favorite is her line. She goes, it's a fair cop.
It's so aware of what it is that it's shocking to me.
Like the gorilla hand that just reached in and grabbed the storyteller's hand off the book. Like, that's ridiculous. And so is the fact that they're not riding horses and they have patsies that are fucking slamming coconuts together. Great cut. Great cut.
It's like
the framing is also fun. Because you get the castle and them, and they're cut at like a weird funky spot. You're not really seeing everything you want to see. It's a movie that makes you want more.
I'm about to go real AP AP world history on you. So the reason that the kings got to be kings was because God chose them. God was like, "I pick you, motherfucker, to run this bitch."
There are two things that God has chosen, and it was Jewish people and kings.
Yeah,
those are God's chosen people.
And
monarchy goes hard.
How do you get chosen?
Born in the right family.
Yeah. You're born in the right family.
Your dad fucks your cousin.
Yeah.
And you have a fucked up, like, you can't breathe right.
So that's the king.
You can't breathe right, you gotta overbite.
Well, look at this shit.
This is incredible.
They're ripping ass into the trumpets.
Wait a second. Rick and Morty is this but modern. Like, this kind of absurdity where it's just like, what the fuck?
I don't agree.
It doesn't have the same quality.
I see it a little bit. I see it
like
a little
there,
bit.
There are, there's a comparison to be drawn, but this is higher quality. Like, that actually caught me off guard. It wasn't, like, desensitized.
I think it was because this was more, like, not, like, edgy, but, like, boundary pushing in the 70s versus when they do it now where it's, like,
yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
It's a style now. Because this led the way for it.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Okay. Skip like this, it makes me remember that there are some people who, like, don't know how to skip.
Yo, quick, let's get a quick tally of the room. Who knows how to skip?
Can you skip, Gavin?
Huh? What was that?
You
can
look
you
like you
skip?
Can skip.
Oh, yeah.
What?
Do you know how to skip?
Kip? I don't know what that
skip.
Is. I don't know what that is. Anyway,
skip.
Yo, Bree is
oh,
gonna
I love
cock
this part.
Her mic
I love
back
this
and right at your forehead. Can you not skip, motherfucker?
No, I can skip. I can skip.
You can skip.
I can skip. Yeah.
You can skip.
Yeah.
Sing it right now.
Not a single lesson.
But you hit that shit on stage, though.
Mm-mm. I didn't get any rehearsal time either. I don't know the words to this song. They shot.
Is it the door?
Yeah.
It's like plywood, but it's like plywood.
It does look like plywood.
And that's great. That's
because it was probably an open archway at the castle that they could get, and they were like, we got to attach without fucking their shit up. Defeat
at the castle. Okay, wait, this is a good fourth wall break. There's a lot of fourth wall breaks in certain movies that I don't like, and this is done well.
The thing of great that's about this one is we don't realize it's a fourth wall break yet.
Yeah, these fourth wall breaks are framed as like a B plot in the film.
Alex is the one with the glasses. I have the long hair, and then you're just the template. You're like, that's like Mario.
Jack,
Luigi.
Jack is our Luigi. Jack's our professional Hamptons cowboy.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, you've got bad breath. Well, it's only because you don't brush my teeth. You don't brush my teeth?
He doesn't have the arms.
Are you an idiot? Yes. Yes, I am.
Yo, I think we got the wrong Monty Python movie. I think we got Mounty Python.
Gavin, what Nobody are the odds Ringo? You wear this white outfit?
To what?
Or just like for the rest Gavin of my life? Like a maid?
To school.
To school? That'd be good. I say
You could just pop into a fashion class and like
I
be
converted to a different religion.
Yeah, yeah. What are the odds? If I find this outfit, or better yet, if I make it for you.
Oh, you find it and do it for me? That's even better.
Oh, fuck yeah.
50.
50?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yep.
1, 2. Wait,
oh, okay. 3, 2, 1. Not 1, 2, 3.
All right. Excuse me. Ready? 3, 2, 1. 37.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Okay, so since we got that little sneak peek, you think we can estimate the budget?
Oh, shit.
Oh, I can. I bet I can. I'm going to give it 8 million.
I'm going to say like 400,000. It's less than 2 million. I'm going to say that. That's going to be my...
I'm going to hit it at 4 million.
The budget for this movie was 229,000.
Really?
That is now the closest I've ever been.
That's actually that's
which
a little crazy.
$291,000.
I mean, they still have like so much like costumes and sets like.
I wonder like where the most of
all the sets are shitty though. Like that's part of it.
Yeah.
But I wonder where the bulk of
like
their money
look at that. That's terrible. Like the like that's.
Yeah, all they did was fucking fog for this right there. That's probably like all
and
they did.
This very well could have been smoke.
Yeah.
It was the 70s.
Do you want to guess what they grossed worldwide? And this is in U.S. dollars. They made a profit. This is from the box office, not in perpetuity, just box office.
2-3 million?
1.9 million. That is officially the closest we've been.
Dude, I'm killing it right now.
1.9 million?
1.9 million at the box office.
I would have thought it was even bigger than that.
$45,000 opening weekend.
$45.
Where would you go to get a shrubbery?
The arborist?
Look at Hampton's cowboy over here, pulling out these big words.
Where would you go to get a shrubbery?
What exactly does a shrubbery look like? Does you it look how it sounds?
Yes.
Have you never heard the term shrub before?
I've heard shrub.
That's short for shrubbery.
But is it just a bush? Is that all it is?
It's a shrub.
Jesus rub Christ.
Rev him up like a long
rapper.
Aw, he's gay. He just wants to sing.
What are the odds they do this movie, but everybody's wearing Tim's?
Do you want me to give you a fun fact about the costuming for this movie?
I do.
All of the chainmail that they're wearing is knitted. It's not metal at all. It's yarn.
I love that. Look at this fit. That Lancelot's in right now.
Yo, this
fire fit.
This Gavin for real.
He ran into it himself.
He did have a drinking problem.
It's a disease.
You know
is
who's
that when he comes
I want to know? Captain America. Did Captain America see this movie?
Captain America would want these people burned at the stake for witchcraft, okay? He's what, 90 to 100 years old?
Yeah.
And you expect me to believe he's going to be fucking normal?
I was
no! Dude, this is art department during lunch break.
You can see the grips grabbing all the beef sticks.
The grips are grabbing the beef sticks. Art is dancing in a circle with flower crowns.
I love how he starts fucking killing it.
I know. This is such...
the note's very specific, too. It's like, I'm sorry, dude. It's like I've got this specific beef with my father, who's got me locked up trying to marry a girl against my will. And he just goes
he's,
and swings
no,
ten
he
toes
is,
down.
Yeah, he is murking everybody.
He doesn't get let out often.
Well, and what I love about this too is that they're trying to figure out how to up the stakes and whatnot. So
it's just everybody's
like, yeah, and because that's where the B plot is.
Just killing them. He's knocking shit out of their hands. For
Gavin, do you think this is camp?
No.
Okay.
No.
Why don't you think it's camp?
It's too self-aware. If it was like totally like without the context of it being a comedy and this scenario, it would be camp. But because it's a comedy, it's not camp.
Okay, Jack, I have a question for you.
Hit me.
So it was shot on 16mm.
Yeah.
And I feel like it does look very kind of rinky-dink. Mm-hmm. Can you kind of give me a rundown of how that changes things? Because like it still looks like there's still a good sharpness to it.
So that'll come from the lenses more often than not. Basically, you're dealing with, as opposed to like pixels, you're dealing with chemicals. There's no real like limit to how sharp they can get, theoretically. As sharp as the lens gets, your film will match that. So they're probably shooting on really sharp glass. But what 16mm does do is, since they're using the same like plastic strip for the film, you have the same kind of imperfections that are now twice the size relative to your exposure. So like the size of your exposure is cut in half. 35mm. It's smaller. It's a smaller negative.
Okay, but like I'm still watching it big screen.
Yeah.
So why?
So it's a smaller negative. So the imperfections that it has are bigger relative to its size, because they're the same size as would be on 35mm, except now you're projecting the image larger. So like you're stretching the image more. It's like when you scale up an HD picture to 4K. So like the grain is larger. That's one of the most noticeable things on 16mm. Name is Roger the Shrubber. I arrange, design, and sell shrubbing it up and sneaking away and buggering
off and chickening out and pissing up home. Yes, bravely, he is blowing in the... Dude, this is what's gonna happen after the entire fucking internet goes down and all these TikTok comedians this is what they're gonna wind up doing. They're gonna wind up being fucking jesters.
Okay, but having someone follow you around and like make music to what you're doing is kind of fun.
Yep.
I also really enjoy the like animation style of these cuts.
All
like
Terry Gilliam.
Scenes.
Yep.
I love
who is
that.
One of the members of Monty Python.
So you be falling out of trees like that?
I did once, I've been the same since.
I don't know if it's so much you fell as though
I was pushed.
You were pushed.
Let me retell the story. 1927. Shortly after the Great War, as we called it during that time, I sat in a tree.
This guy stinks!
It's really not that funny.
Yo, Bree, how are you making the flamethrower staff?
By contacting my practical effects team.
I think that,
ooh,
this
fire.
This is Jackass with
fire.
A through line.
Do the caveman voice.
That one?
Yeah.
Fire! Whoa, sorry.
Anyone ever got you like that?
Alex saw red for a second there.
Sometimes you gotta unleash the beast. This bit with the horses is fucking hilarious.
It's also done really well because you don't get tired of it.
It's still funny throughout the movie.
Well, it's just like there, like they added the dismount bit. Where it's like, that was funny. That was a new introduction.
Yeah.
Like, we've seen them running, okay, yeah, it's been funny every time.
It's a little ham puppet in some of the shots, like you saw.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Like, it's great. Like,
they held, like, the shield right here and just went... It's like, that's good. The
holy
hand grenade of Antioch. It is one of the sacred
relics Brother Maynard carried.
They said the
holy
thing.
Holy hand grenade.
They said the thing. Bring up the holy
hand grenade. See, the best part about that B-plot is, now knowing what I know... They're one of my favorite parts because like I can't wait for them to come back. Like I see them, I'm happy. They leave, I'm upset.
It's like there's two different movies. With things like this, specifically comedy like this, I feel like you have to shoot everything and keep nothing. Like I think that might just also be a testament to my own like challenges. I feel like I would run way too wild with it.
Yeah. No,
like I would just run. I would be like, oh my god, we're in fucking Mars now, and like you gotta get it all out. You gotta dump a ton of sand into the sandbox and then try and figure out how to make sandcastles out of it.
Yeah.
This is also really fun. I love this. I love this because it's... I specifically love the way it's done because it's done with like a photoreal texture.
What I really appreciate about the writing of this film is that everything manages to get to like three beats.
Three.
That's better. That's better.
Fuck yeah.
See, isn't this shit so fucking fun?
Even if they didn't have a lot of money and their builds, like, are shitty for what they are, I, as a production designer, love that shit so much. Like, I love it.
Also, I feel like there's a lot of people on this where they were like, I just really love, like, it feels endearing to me. Nobody on this is making money.
But for they still put their dollars. Pussy in it. No, they're on a roll right now.
Oh, yeah, no. They're bebopping and scatting all over these British fools.
Yeah, they threw their poop bucket.
How did you guys like that movie?
Wait, that's
not
it?
Yeah.
That's the whole thing?
Yeah.
I'm left on my seat. I want more.
They all got fucking arrested. They were killing people.
No. The way the story ended, it's like it's left me wanting more. As
I
want to
see them in
never
prison.
Seen it before.
How many movie points would you give it?
I would give it 10 movie points, but cubed. Actually, I take that back. That's 100 cubed. No, 100 divided by 3 cubed.
Can you simplify for us?
No, it's like the whole, it's like parentheses, then cubed.
Well, anyways, I'm going to give it 2 thumbs up. Enthusiastic ones at that.
I give this 4.7 stars.
I'm going to give it 106 movie points.
I respect that review. I think,
Sorry, go ahead.
No.
I interrupted.
Your turn.
Your turn.
No. Your turn.
I was going to say, how long would you need?
Anyways, do you see how that feels?
Yeah. Sorry.
Well, anyways, thank you all for joining us on this very fun, very enjoyable, fantastic comedy movie. Great episode of the Movie Palace all around. Great job, guys. Thank you very much for joining us on this episode of the Movie Palace, where we review movies, some of which we've seen and some we haven't. Thank you very much. Good night.